Samuel L. Raffert III is a dedicated husband, father, and grandfather. He is widely recognized as a highly respected community leader, an advocate for education, and a passionate voice for educational equality and social justice. Throughout his life, he has tirelessly fought for equal educational opportunities for all students, with a particular focus on those from marginalized communities. Currently serving as the director of the Community Action Organization of Western New York, Better Schools, Better Neighborhood, Maston Resource Center in Buffalo, New York, Mr. Raffert oversees and manages a diverse range of programs and services that promote educational and economic opportunities for residents. Mr. Raffert also hosts the popular radio show, We the Parents, on WUFO Power 96.5 Radio. Mr. Raffert has an extensive background and history in parent leadership. Throughout his career, he has held various influential positions, including chairperson for Head Start Policy and Overall Policy Council, president of the parent organization, and president of the District Parent Coordinating Council. He has also been appointed by former New York Governor Andrew Cuomo to serve on a state education commission and represented parents in President Barack Obama's White House Community Leadership Briefing Series for Education. In addition to his influential work in education, lending his expertise to various boards and committees, he has actively served on the Citizens Advisory Council of Buffalo, the Board of Directors for the Education Trust New York, and the National Parents Union. As a testament to his exceptional leadership and unwavering dedication to community service, Mr. Raffert has been honored with numerous awards, including the Buffalo News Citizen of the Year, the Umoja Man of the Year Award, the Community Service Award from the Association of Black Social Workers, the Harriet Tubman Award, the African American Historical Society Award, the Black Achievers Award, the Phi Beta Sigma Education Community Service Award, the Mayor's Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Award, and a Certificate of Special Congressional Recognition, among many others. Leveraging his wealth of knowledge and experience, Mr. Raffert continues to empower parents and advocate for the rights of all of our students, leaving an enduring impact on the educational landscape. Please welcome Dr. Raffert.
Thank you so much. Good afternoon. Come on, graduates, good afternoon. In everything we do, first and foremost, we acknowledge the presence of a true and living God. Amen. We also honor the presence of our ancestors because they are the boats that we came over on. They're the bridge that we got across to get here. But we also honor our elders, and in this case, we're going to do it this way. None of y'all would be here if it wasn't for y'all parents. So we want to just take a minute and have all the parents and grandparents and the aunts and the uncles stand up, and let's give them a big, big thank you for the sacrifices they've made. We got to do better than that. Thank you, parents. Thank you, grandparents. Thank you, aunts. Thank you, uncles. Thank you, family, friends. Because nobody would have been here without you. And we surely want to make sure that we give honor where honor is due. I want to thank the head of schools, Principal Baxter, and the whole leadership team here at Health Science for the great job they did in preparing you for your future. Let's give a big round of applause for the great leadership here at Health Science. A special shout out to my man, Coach Ty. I'm saying, so I was telling the superintendent that one of the best things that happened to me in high school was I got to play for a championship football team, and I didn't know how important that was until later in life. And I know that y'all have one of the greatest coaches in the history of West New York here at Health Science Charter School, and y'all had a great experience. Let's give a big round of applause for Coach Ty. Yes. I had the five things my grandmother told me, but I'm going to be, for the sake of time, I'm going to be bring it down to three, all right? And I'm going to bring it down to three because I don't want to be between y'all and y'all going to this next stage of your life. One of the most important people in my life has been my grandmother. And my grandmother was very, very intentional about teaching me a few lessons in life. So I'm going to give y'all three of those lessons, then I'm going to sit down, all right? The first lesson my grandmother told me is she said, Sam, if two people exactly alike, one of them ain't necessary. Do y'all know what she was saying when she said that to me? Say it with me. If two people are exactly alike, one of them ain't necessary. She said, Sam, she said, you can't, only thing that matters to me is that you be you. She said, ain't no other you on the planet Earth. She said, don't come talk to me about trying to be like somebody else. You can't be nobody else. No matter how hard you try, you will never be successful at being somebody else. Next chapter in life with a commitment to be unapologetically you. The second thing my grandmother told me, she said, if you hang around 9 broke people, you're bound to be the 10th. Now, let's say it again. If you hang around 9 broke people, you bound to be the 10th. My grandmother was trying to say the people you hang around matter. She said, if you, whatever it is that's important to you, whatever you want to do with your life, go find somebody that's already doing that. Spend time with them. Listen to them. Learn from them. That's your best chance at getting where you want to go. That's the advice from Grandma. And the last one that I'm going to share with you today, she said, you learn to dance by doing the dance. Say it with me. You learn to dance by doing the dance. She said, not talking to dance, not reading to dance. She said, you got to go out and you got to do the thing that you want to do. You'll get better. She said, don't worry about failing. How significant that statement she told me. But now I understand it. You learn to dance, you learn to dance by doing a dance. And I'm gonna end this speech, and I'm gonna end it this way. I'm gonna come down here with y'all because I'm gonna end it with what she did with me. She took me. I had got somebody gave me some really bad news. A teacher suggested that I talk too much. Now, she didn't know that was my gift. And that I was going to need to do that for the rest of my life. But it kind of affected me, the way she did that. And so, you know what my grandmother did? She took me to the church to hear Mother Jones's testimony. She asked Mother Jones to give her testimony. And I'm going to leave you with this, the testimony that Mother Jones gave. Mother Jones said that she had got called into a consultation room at Roswell, and the doctor in the consultation room said to her, Mrs. Jones, I got some really bad news for you. He said that you need to get your affairs in order because you're not probably going to live more than 6 months. You have terminal cancer. Now, Mother Jones looked at him and she said, how old are you? Now that seemed like a weird question, don't it? He said, I'm 38 years old. Why? She said, do me a favor. Don't ever do that again. He said, don't ever do what again? She said, let me tell you something, young man. She said, I don't have terminal cancer. She said, what has terminated is your knowledge of what to do. And because you don't know what to do, you want me to go jump in the grave. And she said, I'm not doing that. She said, I'm going to go see if it's somebody that knows more than you. She said, you should have told me to go see, get a second opinion. You should have told me that you've done everything you can do. Because I believe in something greater than you. I believe in something greater than your knowledge. And that force that I believe in has the power to solve any problem, allow me to achieve any goal, and overcome any obstacle. And she trusted that power. And 30 years later, She lived to tell that story. So what am I telling you? Don't let nobody tell you what you can't do. Don't let nobody tell you what's going to happen to you. Trust in a higher power than all of that, the creator of this whole thing. And with that, you can be successful with everything you're going to seek to achieve in your life. Amen.
Thank you, Dr. Rafford, for those moving words. Thank you, baby. Please welcome the Health Sciences Chorus to the stage to sing our alma mater. Now we're gonna play a slideshow dedicated to our senior class.
Dougie, y'all told me he been on some positive, yeah, yeah. Lately, I just wanna show up my body's in, yeah, yeah. Always been a little mathematician. Lately, this cash I'm getting got me losing count of these bags. I've been moving too fast. Hard times don't last. Remember when cops are rats talking out my boy, you ain't for the badge. All my life, they be trying to keep me down. All this time, never thought I'd make it out. No, no. No. All my life, trying to keep me down. I decided I had to finish, but the media called me a menace. I just sat with the mayor and politicians. I'm trying to change the image. You can't blame my past no more. I come from the trenches. Some said I'd never be a superstar, but I know I'm different. I'm a voice, but the system ain't give me a choice. Know some people that still undeployed. I know a fella who trying to get forward. Child support, your only support. For a visit, And you know that I'm famous as see how you gon' joke about stimulus, but they really had came in the clutch. I know some kids wanna hurt themselves. Stop trying to take drugs, I refer to myself. Trying to better myself, trying to better my health, but all my life they be trying to keep me down. All this time never thought I'd make it out. No, no.
They couldn't take me, they couldn't take me.
No.
All my life.
All my life.
They be trying to keep me down.
They be trying to keep me down.
First generation ghetto, cold world, hello. Made it out of the city with my head on straight. Keep shooting up the let out. Yo, enjoy the pill, gotta get out. Cause the shit that I spit out is a cheat code, like I'm facing a Rico. I had to put a hit out. And another one, and another one. I got like 100 of them by the lap. So they think they're ahead of me, but I'm really in front of them now. Some of them fumbling, they bad. Got the little crumbs that they had. A reminder to humble yourself, this could be gone in an instant. Me, I'm running long distance, all pistons firing. I've been stuck between maybe retiring and feeling like I'm just not hitting my prime. These days, seeing rappers be dying way before they even getting they shine. I never even heard a little buddy till somebody murder little buddy. Now I'm on the phone searching little buddy name. Got a plane that's tunes all day in my room. Thinking it's wicked to get their names buzzing. Some just gotta go lay in a tomb. And media thirsty for clicks. I got a new rule. If you ain't never posted a rapper when he was alive, you can't post about him after he get hit. It's simple, it's the principle. On any tempo, I'm invincible. Don't even rap, I just fit to you. I'd rather that than an interview most days. Come on, like I'm going through a whole phase. Young nigga shoot out the whip like road rage. I pray all of my dogs stay so paid. And the only thing to kill him is old age.
All my life,
all my life. They be trying to keep me down.
All this time, never thought I'd make it out. No, no, no. All my life.
Now, what you all have been waiting for. Class of 2023, I just want to let you know that I am so, so very proud of you all. And I love you all. And y'all better come back and visit me. I will cook for you guys if you come back and visit me. Parents and family, professional photos will be taken. If you would like to order, there is a scan code inside of the program, as well as one in the back of, in the front of the church in the entrance. If you would like to take photos a little bit closer, you can come up to the gold rope right here, but please don't pass that rope as we need the space for our graduates. I'll ask that our admin team, along with Dr. Lowe, begin the presentation of the diplomas for the class of 2023.
Diploma. gonna shake your hand and they gonna pose by themselves. First up, Shanice Vaughn. Shanice is the valedictorian and a member of the National Honor Society. Laila Adiola. Anderson. Marche Anderson. Boyd. Burnett. Also a member of the National Honor Society. Eric Crum. Also a member of the National Honor Society. Malik DeBerry. Thank you. Jordan. Makayla Graham. Diploma. Jaden Jones. Jaden is also a member of the top 10. Leonard. Leonard. Dynasty is also a member of the top 10. Kayvon Leonard. A member of the top 10. Malik Lucas. Of the top 10. Tatiana Mangum. Duffy. also a member of the top 10. And a member of the National Honor Society. Dotch Nadala. Marcelina Page. Shazad is a member of the top 10 and National Honor Society. Renaya Reed. Right. Rogers Mumford. Of the top 10. The top 10. Tamaya Swab. Tamaya is a member of the top 10. Talana Ward. Jackson. Congratulations again to our graduating class of 2023.
Since we was on, I dreamed it all. Ever since I was young, they said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation.